Headed to El Paso, 4:45 in the morning. Game's at noon. We got plenty of time to get there. Or as they say, we got a long way to go and a short time to get there. That's a little Smokey and the Bandit for you folks. See you in El Paso.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Nighttime would find me in Rose's Cantina, music would play and Felina would whirl. Blacker than night were the eyes of Felina, wicked and evil while casting a spell. My love was deep for this Mexican maiden, I was in love but in vain I could tell. One night a wild young cowboy came in, wild as the West Texas wind.
Just approaching Wilcox, Arizona, and look at this gorgeous sunrise. Gorgeous Arizona sunrise. The first 2 hours were in pitch blackness. Now it's about 7 o'clock in the morning. And we're about 245 miles away. I'll be getting there around 10:45 El Paso time. The temperature is about 39 degrees. There it is, the sprawling metropolis. The sprawling metropolis of Las Cruces right there. And we're just about 40 minutes away from the Sun Bowl, and it's 40 degrees out here and it's freezing. Okay, here I am at the Sun Bowl. It's freezing here. Well, it's like 45 degrees, but middle of the day, 45 degrees, that's like middle of the night for us. Anyways, I'm gonna go look for some tailgate action now. Okay, I'm freezing my ass off. It's 45 degrees, but the sun feels great. We're gonna be in the sun today, and that's all that matters. A lot of Seminole fans here. And the carne asada in that parking lot, you didn't even have to taste it. You could just taste it in the air. It's so beautiful. And this right here is the Don Haskins Center. This is where Tim Hardaway used to play. In case you didn't know that, from Texas El Paso. And I'm probably one of the few people that only know that. Run TMC with the Golden State Warriors. Look it up, Google it. Don Haskins Center. You don't see this every day. And there you can see the stadium way off in the distance. This reminds me of a early Sun Devil Stadium in like the 1960s, before they added the upper decks. Anyways, going inside the stadium.
Thank you.
They almost took my camera away. They said I can only take pictures with this, no video. So, we'll see about that. Okay, look at the size of that burger. That's the minor burger. Right?
Tell him, coach. Job D back. Job D. Who got it? Lucas? Give it to Lucas. Yeah, he just wasn't.
There's a new boss in town.
Number 10.
So far, so good.
And security staff.
Temperature right now is about 55 degrees and sunny.
Above all,
beautiful day. Nice big crowd on hand. Huge crowd on hand, actually. Almost full.
They're
doing some renovations over there.
Use stadium ramps.
Good. Good.
Offside. Defense number 91.
Jack Jones shaking up there. You see him walking along the sidelines, holding that left hand. Trainer's kind of convincing him to try and go in.
Mira, call the cameras. Throw it.
Nice.
Yes. Yes.
Daniels pass complete to Frank Darby, number
Okay, ASU down 14-9. 13 minutes to go. Interception, baby! Sun Devil just taking the lead in the four. This is the same sweatshirt I wore in 1997 when ASU beat Iowa in the Sun Bowl. I've only worn it like two times since. I broke it out for the night's game special. There's Jayden Daniels' mom right there, enjoying her son's success. And there's Darby with the trophy, carrying it off in the El Paso night. Headed back to Tempe, where it'll sit next to the territorial cap. Final score, Sun Devils 20, Florida State Seminoles 14. We got the Seminoles and the Sun Devils battling it out there in the parking lot.